The Ryu Yonga.
Nobody ever take it.
I had him throw one line. Never would, never will, never could I hurt you.
Hold on. Wait a minute.
Stepped in the camera like that.
But to Gambia and to Mafumbi Dwa.
You, Ghanaian ambassador, the new spokesman for Africa, future international black figure, saran dipped in oil, a rap slicker.
And she told me he was a rapper. So my first instinct was, what? Like, this isn't progress.
Better served than a bad tip, but my singles make him see double as I stack triple till I'm known.
Edwin loves music. He loves it more than me.
Firstborn of Kamateka, Han Karamaji, that's the son of Kabalega. We used to wild out, nowadays, Swatereda. They say I got competitors, where? To Nabareba.
First of all, I think on Visitation, Ryonga had the most grub. So whenever Visitation would come, all of us would always make sure we watch out for Ryonga's car and inform him on his behalf that grub has come.
Sheila is really funny. Like, she's a person who can pause a movie, you're in the middle of a movie and she's laughing and she's trying to tell you exactly what you're from watching. Like, can you believe the guy was like, gah, gah, gah? And you're like, I'm right here with you. I'm watching it with you.
Before he went to the US, and I'm sure his friends know this, Edwin had an accent, eh?
I keep a moving locomotion, and even with my global accent, I'm still getting locomotion.
That was practiced from TV, but if you didn't know him, you would think that he was born and raised in America.
She was like my jogging buddy, walking buddy. Any attempt to lose weight that we ever undertook on campus was purely Sheila's idea, and she's the one who put us through most of it. I remember squash.
The Sprite contest. When he liked basketball, that's something that has not been mentioned yet. It was a passion of his. And we wanted to win a Sprite ball for our little team, yes. And he had to drink all these Sprites at a very fast pace while running around. So Sheila, if he can drink sodas for us, imagine what he can do for you.
We used to fight a lot, big time. We would be friends today, like the whole day, and then in the night we fight over like the puppies, chairs, spoons, like totally nothing. Sibling stuff where you fight over nothing.
The first time I met her, I thought, Bananga, this quiet chick, who's, she's too serious. But the time that I got to know her, she even knows how to speak like Nigerians, my dear. So don't play.
She has this look towards life. She does not give up. She really, really does not give up. When she puts her mind towards something, she determines to do it. She will always ask me, so what do you think about this? Do you think, you know, I want to do this? And you know, I would encourage her and say, yeah, sure, give it a shot. And she wouldn't give up. Even when she was met with obstacles or things didn't go through, she didn't give up.
I call Edwin, really, but trying to get used to the Ryonga.
Ryonga, of course, the whole world knows. I mean, we used to call him Ray-Z back in the days. Ray-Z from Ryonga. I don't know who started it, but I think it was Howard.
When he got saved, he threw away all those names that he used to use. He used to have many names because he is a musician. I can just remember one, I can tell you, but he doesn't use it anymore. Would you still want to hear it? Okay, it's a young whippersnapper.
I personally first heard him sing in our village in Bulindi when he at Christmas, and everyone was a bit shocked that he could actually sing. We always knew him as the rowdy kid, kidding, but yeah, we had him sing the first time in Bolindi, and it was fun, and he was amazing. Many times I've sworn I'm a changed
man if brought out of this jail. He believes in relating with people, and I think that's part of the reason why he became a musician, because he always wants to reach out to people, he always wants to talk to new people and meet new people, and I think his message is basically that one of love and extending a hand to people.
He chose his passion as music, and he's a musician now, and I'm so proud of him because he has accomplished so much, so much. And I think my biggest joy now is that he's using his passion to bless and touch people's lives, you know. He's not just using it for his own satisfaction, but I've seen Edwin when he's preparing for a song. Even after his songs have come out, he sits down and asks himself, has it accomplished what I wanted it to accomplish? Pimps misleading these innocent strangers, getting them to barter whatever they'll bring to the table. Kings trading their crowns for clown hats and party favors. If you ain't figured it out yet, I reside in Vegas, the seventh circle.
Yeah, I remember back in S4, I think, when we used to stay in the cubicle. I think you're the drummer. You used to beat the metallic cases. Bottom dollar yarders barter they. And he used to rap along our beats. We used to beat those metallic cases and make rhythmic beats like. And Ryonga would just come and spit and blow our minds out, would bump our heads, miss lunch. We go late for lunch because we're bumping Ryonga. Man, it was crazy. Lyrically, I'm about to go in. Alphabetical blood spill flowing. Just check my MO. My skill level has no win. The RUYON. DA.
About to do EA to BIG. Way to kick in the. So I remember that time when Ryonga had that show at Katikati, I think. And then we were like, his biggest fans were almost reaching the stage. Me, my sister Anita, Sheila, and some other family friends. And everyone was looking at us like, what's up? Because we're in the VIP, but we were standing next to the stage. And everyone was looking at us like, why are you next to the stage of in the VIP section? But anyway, we loved seeing him on stage because he was performing really nicely, and Sheila was screaming louder than the whole crowd. Our God is humongous. We walk among the
gods, and the gods walk among us. I was right there when he met Sheila for the very first time. Sheila was helping out at church. I happened to be working at church. I'm a youth pastor there. So she was helping out at church. There was this big function for fundraising for a ladies' thing. And so when she saw him, and you know, they saw themselves and their eyes got locked together, things like those, I was right there seeing it all happen.
I met Sheila at a fellowship, the YOMS fellowship, and I was asking her what she'd been up to. And she was like, oh, there's this guy who's taking up my time. And she told me he was a rapper. So my first instinct was, what? Like, this isn't progress, you know? I was like, no, he loves the Lord, and he's Christian folk, basically.
You know, she used to be a hardcore girl. No one, you know, these little boys couldn't stand a chance. Then Ryonga came around and confused her thoroughly. She would come to me and then ask me, this guy is asking me things she doesn't understand. This was 2011 or 12. And now, a few years later, here we are.
And let me tell you something, Sheila has been brought home to meet my mom. Edwin has never, ever introduced any girl to us as a family. The mission of a soldier in the army of Jehovah,
walking, killing it diligent where they hardly ever sober. About marriage life, Ryonga, I would say I'm a married man, yes. And marriage is like a life, a journey. It's what you make it, so make it the best and you'll enjoy it.
Edwin, you have a good lady. Make her happy. Be faithful and just be the prayerful people that you are, and put God at the center of it all.
Take good care of Sheila. If anything goes wrong, I'm the person you'll answer to, among others.
Never will, never would, never could hurt you. So I think, Sheila, that's the thing you should be always listening to from Edwin.
Yeah, my fatty, he used to be. But he used to have hips when he was a kid, so it's amazing how he has lost them.
He always used to compete with me in the hips department. He still has hips, but at least now, you know, he goes to the gym, works out, and clearly Sheila must love him because, you know, she doesn't mind.
I'm trying to lose mine. Don't worry. I hope you're not recording that part. Cut it out, eh?
Thank you, folks. Thank you very much. There you have it. Out.
Y'all don't hear me.
Y'all don't hear me.
Y'all don't hear me.
Nah.